and a woman having an issue of blood 12 years, which had spent all her living upon physicians, neither could be healed. For Eli came behind him and touched the border of his garment, and immediately her issue of blood stanched. And Jesus said, "Who touched me?" And when all denied, Peter and they that were with him said, "Master, the multitude thronged thee and pressed thee, and says, who touched me?" And Jesus said, "Somebody has touched me, for I perceive that which in is gone out of me." And when the woman saw that she was not healed, she came trembling and falling down before him. She declared unto him before all the people for what cause she had touched him, and how she was healed immediately. And he said unto her, "Daughter, be of good comfort. Thy faith has made thee whole. Go in peace." And this is the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Brother Gabogo. Thank you very much, Gabogo. We're going to prepare ourselves to listen to the word of God. This is the oracle. And we're going to stand and sing number 16, Kutoka Tenzi za Rohoni, Kumtegemea Mwokozi Kwangu Tamu Kabisa. Tusimame. Number 16, Kumtegemea Mwokozi. One, two, go.
Kumtegemea Mwokozi Kwangu Tamu Kabisa, kukubali neno lake ninalo moyoni. Yesu, Yesu namwamini, nimemwona kabisa. Yesu, Yesu yuna mali
Zaminene. We come before your throne of mercy, O Lord, because the time has come for you to speak to us. Lord Jesus, you cannot gather your people in vain. There is something special that you have for all of us, O Lord. We want to open our ears now. We want to open our hearts, oh God. Speak to us now, for we are listening. May the meditations of our hearts be acceptable to you, oh Lord. And may all the words of my lips, oh Lord, be acceptable to you too. Bless us now, for we pray this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 You may be seated. I would like to take this opportunity and greet all of you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Can you wave at me? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
What are you feeling?
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
Let me begin by saying that my name is Johnson Wajema Wamwara, and Jesus Christ is Lord and Savior of my life. I gave my life to the Lord when I was still a youth. I was 21 years old, and 28 years later, the Lord has been faithful. I cannot say that the Lord has let me down at any given point. I have walked with the Lord, and He has promised that He will be with me until the end of these times. I remember those many years ago when I had just finished high school back in Kenya. We had to go all the way up to Form 6. And December the 20th, which happens to be my birthday too, that's the time that I surrendered my life to the Lord. And He wrote my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. I am here to testify about the goodness of the Lord. I am here to tell you that it's possible with the Lord.
Amen.
Everything is possible with the Lord. Praise the Lord. So that God has kept me going, and He has made me His own, and above all, has called me into His ministry so that I may become a co-worker with Him.
Amen.
I did not stop when we were singing, because my wife had an opportunity to do that, Ruth. The Lord has blessed us together for the last 19 years and blessed us with two children, Rachel and Sammy. Sammy did not sing with us, but he can play a little bit of keyboard and he plays the saxophone. Maybe next time he'll be able to do that. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We have seen the faithfulness of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
This afternoon, I come to you with the word of the living God. And the title of the message that we're going to share this afternoon is, "If only I touch the hem of His garment." Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And I want us to believe together with this woman who said these words. And I want us really just to have faith, because it's all about faith.
Oh, yes.
Without faith, we cannot be able to achieve anything in our spirituality.
Correct.
Without faith, we cannot be able to reach out unto God. And so I want each one of us to have faith that by the end of this sermon, God is going to do something new in our lives. You know, there are times when people throw their minds back home, back to the people they interact with, and they usually say, as the preacher is sharing the word, "I wish so-and-so was here." It's not for so and so, it's for you and me.
Oh, yeah.
So let's prepare our minds to receive from the Lord, to partake of the table of the Lord, and even to hear what the Lord has in store for us.
Amen.
Well, the stories of Jesus of Nazareth were spreading like wildfire all over Jerusalem, Judea, Galilee, and Samaria. Many people during those over 2,000 years ago talked about Jesus and about His humble background. Some of them were saying, "Oh, behold, the son of a carpenter."
Mm-hmm.
Others were saying, in fact, one time somebody said, "Can anything good come from Jerusalem?" Nothing good, because they looked at Jesus from a different perspective. His stories were spreading all over. Others had spread malicious rumors claiming that Joseph was not the real father to Jesus, because Mary was already pregnant when the two had not even gotten married. Are you getting it? So many were like giving some news and saying, "Oh, wait a minute, we even don't know that child, where he comes from." Let me tell you this afternoon, others were giving evidence of how Jesus had healed them and healed many other people who were sick, and who some of who had already passed away. You remember the story of Lazarus?
Yes.
You remember the story of the widow of Nain, who was on the way in a funeral procession to bury his son? Many people had been resurrected by Jesus. Some people like the Sanhedrin, those that were in charge of the spiritual matters of the synagogue, high priests and teachers of the law, were searching for Jesus in order to make him face the law because of the rumors that Jesus had claimed to be the Messiah. And you know, they never expected the Messiah to come in a humble and a lowly manner the way Jesus came. Many were expecting the Messiah to come like in chariots from heaven. Others thought that he would come with such power that he could be able to overthrow the Roman government and be in charge during that particular time. But when Jesus was born and laid in a manger, many did not believe that he was the Son of God. So many had mixed feelings about who Jesus was. I remember a few years ago, I had an opportunity to go to the land of Israel. And we went to a wall that is called the Wailing Wall, where people go and pray and cry to God in order to answer their prayers. I don't know how that wall was constructed, because the stones are so huge, they are so humongous, but there are clefts in between them. So what people do, they go there as they go for the holy tour in the Holy Land. You write maybe your prayer request and you put it in between the rocks there. We saw a particular group of people who were dressed in black. And all they were doing on the Wailing Wall was like this. And because I was leading a group of about 60 people, we asked our tour guide, who are these and what are they doing? And she said, guess what? This group of people who are a particular kind of a Jewish group of people, they don't believe the Messiah has come yet. Can you imagine? Some of us were going to just to confirm about where Jesus was and all that he did. Yet others who were born in the land of Israel were there still waiting for a Messiah to come. I don't know what kind of a Messiah they were waiting for. Other people during the times of Jesus were just what I may call curious onlookers who wanted to see this man of Nazareth with no apparent reason. Nasema nini? Kuna watu ambao walikuwa wanamtazama huyu Yesu wakimfuata tu kuangalia mambo ambayo watayatenda, lakini hawakuwa na jambo lingine katika maisha yao. Aduwalea maji ya natu kuerone na maigwa Jesu wego huko, magadi yoko muerone na noma tiani maodo dhine wango roshiao. Kana ni maji ya dhile muwada ni amekireo du. Many people had different reasons to meet with this Jesus. Jesus, in this portion of the scripture, had been moving from one village to the other. And the Bible says, wherever he went, he did good. Popote alipo enda, alitenda mambo mema. He had just exorcised evil spirits and cured diseases from some women who then became supporters of his ministry shortly before this portion of the scripture. In fact, among some of the women that Jesus had healed were Mary, who was called Mary Magdalene. And guess what? Mary Magdalene had demons that had disturbed her over the years. And Jesus was able to exorcise those demons out of Mary Magdalene, and then she became a follower of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Amen. That is exactly what the Lord Jesus is able to do for us when we come to him by faith. What about another lady called Joanna, the wife of Chuza? She had been healed by Jesus prior to this portion of the scripture. Oh, the manager of Herod's household. In fact, that Joanna was the wife of Chuza, the manager who was managing the affairs of Herod's palace. That lady had been healed by Jesus. Susanna and many others had received healing from Jesus. And after the healings, guess what? These women decided to help and support the ministry of Jesus out of their own means. About the parable of the sower. The importance of lighting a lamp and placing it on a lampstand. In fact, Jesus had just calmed the Sea of Galilee out of the raging storms that were raising in the Sea of Galilee. and had even exorcised demons from a gentleman in the village of Gerasenes, who had been tormented for many years by evil spirits and who lived in the tombs. What am I trying to say? Kulikuwa na jamaa mmoja ambaye alikuwa amepagawa na mapepo na ambaye maisha yake yote alikuwa akiishi makaburini. Huyu alipokutana na Yesu, praise the Lord, aliponywa na alipoponywa kukawa na furaha kwa watu wengi, lakini kwa wengine kukakuwa na kilio. Instead of welcoming Jesus for freeing this man, the Bible says, all the people of the village of Gerasenes asked Jesus to leave them because they were overcome with fear. What am I trying to say? Can you imagine Jesus coming like to this place, Kent, does something good, heals a person, and instead of the multitudes and the people of Kent welcoming Jesus in order to continue to do more good, we choose to chase Jesus away just because we've been overcome with fear. What am I trying to say? If Jesus was living in our time, I would imagine, and maybe some of us were attending to this man who was possessed with evil spirits. Like some of us are working in the group homes, are we not? Some of us working in Western State, are we not? Maybe if Jesus had done something good like this, I would see some people say, if he continues to exorcise demons from these guys, they talk wagamawira. And maybe that is what happened in the village of Gerasenes. Maybe there are people who were paid by the government to go take care of this guy who was living in the tombs. And now there was no more job. So the Bible says, the fear gripped the people of Gerasenes. And instead of welcoming Jesus to do more good, they chased him away. They say, we don't want any other healing from this man. Mawira maitore mekorera, totikuwa na wakuru tawira. Hatutapata nafasi ya kufanya kazi hii Yesu akiponya watu katika kijiji chetu. So, Jesus got into the boat and went to the other side of the Sea of Galilee and left that city. See how sad it can be. Instead of welcoming Jesus because he's doing something good, people chased him away. And he chose to go. So he hopped back onto the boat and crossed for 30 minutes and went to the other side of the city. Do you know that the Bible says people from the other side were waiting for him? Hallelujah. Oh, yes. And that's exactly what I want us to do this afternoon. I want us to have an expectant heart of waiting to see what the Lord is able to do. Amen. Because people who welcome Jesus, they will never be the same again. Something new, something good is going to happen if we expect, or if we have an expectant spirit, an expectant heart for the Lord to come in. So people on the other side were waiting for Jesus. Well, just like any other normal day, the sun was just about to set that particular day. And Jesus, together with his disciples, arrived on the other side of the lake. And as I have mentioned, many people were waiting for his return. Among these people was a woman who the Bible says had bled for 12 consecutive years. Miongoni mwa wale waliokuwa kimtarajia na kumgojea Yesu ngambo ya pili ya ziwa la Galileo, alikuwa ni mama mmoja mwanamke ambaye alikuwa amevuja damu kutoka ndani ya mwili wake kwa muda wa miaka 12. Alikuwa amesubiri kurudi kwake Yesu ili aweze kumponya. The Bible says this would be similar to a condition referred to medical practitioners as hemorrhage, which is an excess loss of blood, mainly from ruptured vessels. What am I trying to say? It was not easy for this woman. Blood gushing out of her body, not for 3 days in a month, not for 4 days, but for 12 consecutive years. It must have been very, very painful for this woman. This woman, whose name remains unknown to this day, Even Bible commentators will not tell you or guess what the name was. But it just says a woman. Oh yes, this woman who was nameless. Allow me to call her the nameless woman. Praise the Lord. Today, your name and my name are recognized by the Lord. Amen? Amen. If Jesus could do something to a nameless woman, hallelujah,
Amen.
He's able to do much more than we have asked him.
Oh, yes.
Because he has called us by name.
Oh, yes.
And if he can number the hairs on our head, there is nothing that he does not understand about you, about me, and whatever is going on with our lives.
Amen.
This woman, can you imagine, was usually categorized with people who were suffering from leprosy.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, in the days of old, somebody who was suffering from leprosy, they were not supposed to mingle with the other people. They were exonerated from the community, banished from mixing with normal people, as they would call it. And most of the times they lived out of the gates of Jerusalem.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because according to the law of Moses, they were unclean. And anybody who was unclean was not supposed to mix with somebody who was clean. So they were left out there. And for this reason, the woman too had been left on her own and would not be allowed to mix with the other people according to Moses' law in the book of Leviticus. Well, this woman could not share her love intimately with a man, not even her husband. If she was married, the Bible doesn't say whether she was married or not. Why? Because according to the apocalyptic law of Moses, she was unclean and so not user friendly for that matter. If we may use the language of the computers that we have today and all this technology that we have, she was not user friendly. Oh yes, this woman, of course, was not allowed to mix with people. This woman, whenever she came closer to people who are whole in their lives, she was supposed to announce that she is unclean so that people can clear the way. Can you imagine? Ati mutumio yoneto duwore ahanaga. Nako ya jirotamodo wena, wena dhahu. Agiokie haku henado. Agirile kwea nerera. Oye, dire moderu, adu makamwe herera. People would run away from her. Because that was the order of the day. This woman could not be allowed in the synagogue or even in the place of worship until she would get healed and be declared whole again by a high priest or by people who are taking care of the flock of the Lord that time. At times when I read this portion of the scripture, I usually believe, as the Bible in fact says, this woman must have visited so many hospitals in order to get her healing. The Bible says she had exhausted all her means of livelihood.
Mm-hmm.
She could not find a solution to her problem. If she had been living in some parts of Kenya, many would have said, someone has bewitched her, or someone has cast a spell on her. Koro mutumio ewa toraga Kenya le, amwe koduko mwe Kenya le, adomwe magiu ga terere, oe yokai aronga etu ondo. Huh? Oe yokai kareke, one modu muronge, miakai komina ere na kane yumaga deinu amwe ere wake. In fact, she could have consulted so many witch doctors seeking for a solution to her problem. But listen to me, church. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This particular day,
Amen.
She woke up determined to live what I may call a purpose-driven life, according to Pastor Rick Warren. This woman woke up with a purpose in her life because she wanted to meet with a man from Galilee. At times I think it's more dramatic than we read it in the Bible. This woman must have woken up that day, that particular day, and declared this. Today is the day of my appointment with my destiny. in terms of my debilitating condition. For 12 years, my situation has remained the same. I have tried everything, but nothing seems to have worked in my favor. Maybe that was a cry, kiliochahaki, from deep within the heart of that woman that particular day. This nameless woman had heard about the miracles that Jesus was performing. Niwete oira wado mwara yama koiga at oira geto gana na Jesu kumo Nazareti. Hivi no amohonie. Praise the Lord. Maybe other people had told her, why not try Jesus this time around? So that particular day, she wanted to try Jesus. This woman might have heard about how Jesus had healed Mary Magdalene, how Jesus had already healed that other lady or those other women, Joanna and Susanna. Mm-hmm. And she said, what? Today is my day. Leo misiku yangu. Praise the Lord. She said, today is my day. I want to believe that when she woke up that day, she declared, today is the day of my miracle. Alipoamka asubuhi ile, naamini kwamba alijiambia na akatangaza kwamba leo ndio siku yangu ya muujiza. I don't know what you came to find in the house of the Lord this afternoon. I don't know what your prayer is like, because maybe I was not there when you were making your prayer before you came into the house of the Lord. But for this woman, that particular day, she declared, today is the day of my miracle. This woman, she had faith that if Jesus had done good to others, that if Jesus had healed others, he could do the same to her that particular day. This woman said, I'm going to look for Jesus today. Hallelujah. Amen. She told herself, today I'm going to look for Jesus.
Oh, yes.
It doesn't matter where he is, but yes, where the Lord is, I will be there. Where Jesus of Nazareth is, I will be there. Because I believe he's going to do something new to me.
Amen.
This woman must have prayed that morning. And maybe made a prayer like they used to do in the days of old and said, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob, bless me today or else I die. No problem to be a sure how you know how you know. Akira gaiwe gaiwa Ibrahim gaiwa Isaka gaiwa Jacob oda dime omode na wala koda dima nyenongo kwa. Oh yes, heal me today, oh Lord, or never again. She must have knelt down at her house. She must have wept before God. And maybe the prayer could have gone like this, like David says in Psalm chapter 61. Hear my cry, O God. Attend unto my prayer. From the ends of the earth will I cry unto thee. And when my heart is so overwhelmed, O Lord, please lead me to the rock that is higher than I. For thou hast been a shelter unto me for 12 years. And a strong power for my enemies. For 12 years I've suffered, O Lord. Today I pray, lead me to that rock that is higher than I.
Oh, yeah.
Today, O Lord, I take refuge in you. Do not, O Lord, put me to shame forever.
Amen.
With this prayer, with this faith that could move mountains, the woman rested her case before God.
Amen.
Mahoya Maya. We take your oyo, motumi oyo, akirehe, maodomake, namatanya make, kurega iwake. And she said, if only I touch the hem of his garment, I will be made whole. That was her prayer. She did not want to go and maybe shout out at Jesus, like people suffering from leprosy did in those days of old. But she said, if only Nari koroda hutia ishoreshi aguo yake. Toduda shihutia. Nego hona. Yule mama akasema, ikiwa nitaguza upinde wanguo ya Yesu, mimi nitapona. And then she rested her case before her maker. If you need a miracle in your life, my brother, my sister, you must take a step of faith by going out to look for Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
No
muhakatunga niyaga kumana muagani na kumwega korea agioneka. We have to take that step of faith. The Bible, as was read by our brother during the beginning of the service, the Bible says in Isaiah chapter 55 verse 6, seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Jesus, when he is near. The Bible says, let the wicked forsake their ways, and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them turn to the Lord, and he will have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will freely pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. Guess what? As the woman went out looking for Jesus by the shore of the Sea of Galilee, the sun was setting and dusk was appearing that night, that evening. I would believe that this woman declared in her heart, neither dusk nor darkness is gonna prevent me from getting my miracle today from Jesus of Nazareth. Namuona mwanamke huyo akisema kwamba hata kiza kikija, hata machele ya jua yaje, hakuna ambacho kitanizuilia kupata muujiza wangu kutoka kwa huyu Yesu Mnazareti. Nitamtafuta hadi nimpate. Praise the Lord. I would imagine this woman started that journey of faith, going to where Jesus was. And as this woman neared where Jesus was, she must have encountered some major obstacles before her miracle.
Oh, yes.
Thousands of people, the Bible says, were surrounding Jesus. Kulikuwa na halaiki kubwa sana ya watu waliokuwa wamemzunguka Yesu mahali ambapo alikuwa, such that it was impossible to go and reach closer to where Jesus was. Obstacle number one, it was almost impossible to penetrate. Have you ever at times found yourself caught up in this kind of a quagmire and wondering, when will my day of miracle be? How can I reach out to Jesus so that he can do something for me? The woman knew, but she had purposed in her heart that unless she touches Jesus, then she might not get her healing. This woman declared in her heart, nothing is gonna stop me from reaching my healer. For I am persuaded, if only I touch the hem of his garment, I'm gonna be made whole again. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I imagine a situation whereby some people recognized this woman. Imagine. They recognized her. Uragana kame kahinda kame ya kaiko minaeri. Todoro ne maame nyekaga. Mundo we na maako neame nyekaga. Kubo, I would imagine, as she approached normal people recognized her. And when they recognized this woman, they must have rebuked her and said, you unclean woman, what business do you have? Na nyurame nyewe. Mundo we na mogiro. Listen to me, church. I see the woman determined in her heart and declaring to her distractors, I know I am unclean, but you will not stop me from reaching out for my miracle. Praise the Lord. What is it that is going to prevent you this afternoon from getting your miracle? Is there anything that is going to prevent you from reaching out to Jesus? My brother, my sister, there are so many distractors on the way.
Oh, yes.
As we reach out to Jesus for our miracles, maybe the devil tonight is telling you, Jesus will do nothing regarding your situation. Maybe that is the other voice that is coming into your mind. This is the Lord Jesus that I'm talking about this afternoon. Have you the day of your appointment with destiny?
Amen.
Do not leave this place the same again. Like this woman, The Bible says the moment she touched the hem of the garment of Jesus, yes, she received her healing.
Amen.
Instantly. In fact, the Bible says, akihona ole mwe. Dakame getiga komuma dino amwele wake. Akapoke uponyaji papo hapo. Nadamu ikacha kubuja kutoka ndani ya mwili wake. Oh yes, that's what I'm talking about. Oh, as she stretched her hand, she received her healing. Because she had faith that that day, God is going to do something for her. Listen to me, church. I would imagine her pain turned out into excessive relief.
Oh yes.
Can you imagine somebody who has been just in that kind of a state, all of a sudden you receive a healing?
Mm-hmm.
That pain disappeared instantly. And she received such a relief. She came to Jesus with blood spots on her tray, but went back home whole that day.
Amen.
This woman came to Jesus rejected, but went back home that evening, accepted even by the people that had earlier castigated her.
Amen.
And rebuked her and told her, what business do you have with the people who are whole?
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to tell you, church, this woman came to Jesus secretly for her healing. She did not announce it loudly, but just squeezed her way all the way to where Jesus was. She came secretly to where Jesus was. But by the time she went home that evening, after meeting with Jesus, she became what I call breaking news in the social media. And you can't call it Jesus, na jira ya hido. So dareda kuoneka na, ando mahota kumogirele niya, todwe na mogiro, lakamendero ima mwehe ilo hake. No mahida maria ato ganile na kehutisho ni shagwe ya Jesus. Agetweka newsi. Hey, maybe the breaking news would go like this if it was today. A woman receives healing after 12 years with hemorrhage. Mwanamke apona baada ya kuguza upinde wa nguo ya Yesu na amekuwa na ugonjwa huu wa kuvuja damu kwa muda wa miaka 12. She came secretly, but later that evening she became breaking news. Praise the Lord. That is the testimony. She came to Jesus with sadness, but left after touching the hem of the garment of the Lord with a lot of joy. Hallelujah. Akakuja kwake huyu Yesu akiwa na huzuni ndani ya moyo wake. Lakini alipokutana na Yesu akaguza upinde wa nguo yake, akatoka mahali pale akiwa amejaa furaha ndani ya moyo wake. She came to Jesus with a burden, but left free and free indeed.
Amen.
Akaja kwa Yesu akiwa amebeba mzigo wa ugonjwa wake.
Mm-hmm.
Lakini alipoguza upinde wa nguo ya Yesu, akatoka mahala pale akiwa amewekwa huru. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, she came to Jesus embarrassed, but went back home comforted.
Amen.
She came to Jesus hiding her face in her hands. Korea no mambo menyaga na korea no magi amugirereye gukinyera Jesu kongo okire hare Jesu negera ahonio mulimo wake ehinete na moko make andu matikone othio wake. No mahinda maria athunganire na Jesu, she came out there, showed a high for everybody to see what the Lord is able to do.
Amen.
That's the Jesus that I'm talking about.
Yes.
She came to Jesus ashamed, but went back home proud. Hallelujah.
Amen.
She came to Jesus rejected, but even his own family, because of her condition. But when she left the place where Jesus was, she was accepted.
Amen.
That's what I'm talking about this afternoon.
Amen.
That is my Jesus that I want to tell you about.
Amen.
That is the Lord who is able to do much more than we have asked him.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes. This woman came to Jesus while everybody was running away from her. Kukawa watu walikuwa wanamtorokea. Alipokuwa anajaribu kumfikia Yesu, akaja kwa Yesu, wale watu wengine wakimtorokea kwa sababu ya kuwa kwamba she was unclean.
Oh, yeah.
But later when she met with Jesus, she went home being embraced and being lifted high by the same people.
Yes.
You remember the story of Jesus?
Uh-huh.
A week before his crucifixion,
uh-huh,
people said, "He is our King.
Uh-huh.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of."
Uh-huh.
But a week later, crucify him,
uh-huh,
crucify him,
uh-huh,
crucify him. That's the nature of humanity.
Uh-huh.
She came to Jesus rejected by the same people. But the moment she received her healing, everybody wanted to be associated with her. Because when Jesus does something, we will never remain the same again. It will be a testimony even to the others. She came to Jesus unloved. Nobody wanted to be associated with her. But went back home overflowing with a lot of love and everybody embracing her. Because of what Jesus did to her. She came to Jesus weak, malnourished, hiding her shame in her clothes so that people would not see the blood. But that evening, when she went back home, she went back home strong. Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah.
And walking straight.
Amen.
No more trying to bend and squeezing her way to Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
Because she had received her miracle.
Correct.
She came to Jesus discouraged, but went back home that evening encouraged.
Amen.
She came to Jesus with a broken and a contrite heart.
Oh, yes.
That sacrifice that is acceptable before God.
Correct.
But that evening when she met with Jesus, she went back home with a mended whole heart. Because she was never the same again. This is the Jesus that I'm talking about.
Correct.
She met with Jesus of Nazareth. She met with the Son of God.
Amen.
She met with the Lady of the Valleys.
Mm.
She met with a good shepherd who gave up his own life for the sake of his sheep.
Amen.
She met with Jesus who says, "When I give you life, I will give you life and life in abundance."
Amen.
She met with the one who was flogged. She met with Jesus through whose stripes we have received our healing.
Amen.
She met with he who was willing to restore her back to her family and back to her community.
Amen.
This is my Jesus that I'm promising you this afternoon.
Amen.
She met with the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world.
Oh, yeah.
Have you met with the Lamb of God? She met with the beloved Son of God whom we must listen to. She met with my Jesus who was nailed on the cross because of our sins.
Oh, yes.
She met with the one who cried on the cross, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani," which in Aramaic it means, my Lord, why hast thou forsaken me?" He met with the one that was forsaken even by his Father in heaven because of your sins and my sins. Because he chose to carry our sins on the cross, rejected even by God, so that you and I could be accepted. She met with my Jesus, who was forsaken, so that we could be accepted. She met with my Jesus, who declared on the cross, "It is finished." Akakutana na Yesu aliyetangaza msalabani, mambo yote yamekwisha sasa. That's the Jesus that I'm talking about.
Amen.
Today, my brother, my sister, as I wind up this sharing, you may have come into the house of the Lord. And maybe you have a prayer concern that you have. I don't know what your situation is. I don't know what it is that has bothered you for such a long time like this woman. I don't know what kind of a burden you have been carrying in your heart for such a long time. I do not know what it is, but listen to me this afternoon.
Oh, yeah.
Today, Jesus is here, and if only we reach out to him by faith,
oh, yeah,
our lives will never be the same again.
Amen.
Our situations will never be the same again. Our conditions will never be the same again. Maybe tonight you came here sick in your body, and you need the Lord to heal you. Come on, we're going to pray together with you. So as I continue, make your way out here. We'll make a special prayer to the Lord. Because wherever the Lord is, he will always do good. No, ukoro ukire ha hokira mwana ni ngweda oho nie. Togo throna grace e hando ha ha. Oyu tukore tutuke hoera. Na nimura menya doibire kenya kahida karaya. Kana tiguo. Maudu agatunga na yundu itahana. No mwadhani aliona hinya. Praise the Lord. Maybe you are sick in your body and you came here looking for Jesus. I want to promise you something nice tonight. You will never be the same again. Come down the aisle and we're going to make a prayer, a special prayer for you. Maybe you came this evening discouraged in your heart. The Lord would like to encourage you tonight. Make your way over here and we are going to pray together with you. Maybe you came this evening with that notion that nobody loves you. But I promise you, the moment you come into contact with Jesus, Jesus is going to change that around and you will be called the loved one because Jesus is love. Maybe you came this afternoon to the house of the Lord hooked up in what I call pornography. Many times you have tried to stop it, but you find yourself still perusing those pages on your computer, on your phone.
Oh, yes.
Maybe the same things that you don't want to do, you find yourself doing them. Maybe you have crashed your computer. You have broken it because you want to break out of that bonding.
Uh-huh.
It has never worked. Jesus is here. He can set you free. And you will never be the same again. Hallelujah. That's my Jesus that I'm talking about. Maybe you are here. Things will never remain the same again. Maybe you are here and you are discouraged because you have received sad news from your family back in Kenya. Or maybe back somewhere else out there. And you don't know how you're going to be helped. Maybe your children are back in Kenya. Things are happening. But you don't have the capability and the ability to go back and give them a wise counsel. Let me tell you, come down here and we are going to pray together with you. Because Jesus can be able to reach them out there. He doesn't need the papers to go and touch those family members back in Kenya. He doesn't need even an air ticket. He can do it by faith if you believe on their behalf. God can do it and nobody else can do it. Maybe you came out here, you've been looking for a job. And it seems like all doors are closed. I have good news for you. The Lord says, I have good plans for you to give you a future and a hope. And you will be my son, my daughter, and I will be your God. He's going to open those doors. Hallelujah. God does not need keys to open doors of blessing. He can open a door ahead of you if another one has closed it behind you. Him alone and nobody else can do. And we are going to pray together with you. Maybe you are here. You have never ever given your life to the Lord.
Amen.
Paul says in Romans chapter 1, beginning from verse 18, men will have no excuse. We will have no excuse before God on the day of judgment. Or we will not be able to give reasons as to why we never surrendered our lives to Him. Why? Because even nature testifies about the Lord. Hata tukiangalia mazingira yanatangaza kuhusu uwepo wa Mungu. Kwa hivyo hatutakuwa na vijisababu vya kwa nini hatukutoa maisha yetu kwake huyu Yesu. Maybe you are caught up in what I call, maybe you become an alcoholic. You've been drinking ukanywa ukeliwo. I don't know how many tickets you have received. Ni ugereki utigana na ajohi. You have been hooked into that. Maybe it's not only alcohol. Maybe these are drugs that are messing you up.
Oh, yeah.
Nobody knows about it, but you do know. God knows, and the devil knows. And you have tried to stop it, but it has never stopped. Listen to me. Jesus is here.
Amen.
We're going to make a prayer for you tonight.
Oh, yes.
And you'll never be the same again. Soon you're going to come back into this house that is called by the name of the Lord. And give a testimony about how God has set you free. Maybe you are hooked up into immorality. Hidden, hiding in your place of work. Hiding in those group homes. Hiding, thinking that nobody sees you. Guess what? The Lord has seen you. The Lord has seen you. Macho ya Mungu yanasa habari kokote ulipo, kokote nilipo. Chochote tunachotenda hakijafichwa machoni pa Mungu. Na leo Bwana anasema ni siku yako. It's your day of appointment with your destiny. Come on, we are going to make a prayer together with you. Amen. You will never remain the same again. And from today, you will testify about the goodness of the Lord, even in those places of work. And people will start asking, come over here and we're going to make a special prayer together with you. Make it your purpose tonight. Tell the Lord, pass me not, O gentle Savior. Hear my humble cry. While on others, God is faithful, He's able to do it, and you'll never be the same again. Finally, maybe you have some unmentioned prayer request. Unmentioned prayer request. Maybe something that has nagged you. A situation, a condition that you cannot even be able to share with anybody. Listen to me tonight. Jesus is here. He knows about it and He wants to set you free out of it. He wants to bring a solution to that. All I may ask, make your way forward here as we sing, pass me not, O gentle Savior. If you fall in all those categories and you have a need, a personal need or a prayer request, or you want to step in the gap on behalf of others, your family, your husband, your wife, your children, who have deviated from the ways of the Lord, though you have laid a very firm foundation in them, come over here and we're going to make a special prayer. Pass me not, O gentle Savior. Yeah.
Have a purpose. And what is your purpose tonight? to see the Lord doing mighty and great exploits.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mighty and great exploits.
Amen.
It's a matter of walking in faith.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We walk in faith because the woman walked in that faith and he touched the head of the cow. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Baba katika jina la Yesu. Tunakushukuru, tunakuinua adhuhuri ya leo. Kwa vile Baba umetenda na kama vile ulitendea yule mama. Hata nasi kwa imani tumejua kwamba umetutendea.
Yes.
Na tutokapo mahala hapa Bwana tunaomba ukatusaidia roho zetu. Kuwa roho zimejawa na imani. Baba katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Kama vile mama aliponywa. Hata nasi tunaomba ukaponya mioyo yetu. Ukaponya miili yetu. Ukaponya mawazo yetu. Ukaponya njia zetu. Ukaponya familia zetu. Utuponye kanisa letu Bwana. Katika jina la Kristo Bwana. Tuna haja nawe mfalme. We are in need of you God. In every situation we are in need of you. And this is our purpose. Dismiss us with your love, O God. Dismiss us with your grace. Dismiss us with your peace that surpasses every human understanding. Let your amazing and sufficient grace walk us through in the course of the week. Until we meet on Sunday, that we may continue to proclaim of the faithfulness of this God.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for the word because your word is sharper than any two-edged sword. We thank you that your word shall never return to you in a void. We thank you for tonight. Even as we continue in this fellowship, with this fellowship, God, we pray that your presence be together with us. Now as we dismiss to go and continue with the fellowship at Mama and Baba's joyous place, O God, bind us together with a cords of love that can never be broken and lead us with that love, O God, and dismiss us with that love. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen and amen. Amen. We have the address.